I'm not around. I'm the last but only swank. They came and say, carry on my leg, swank.
Thank you. Alexa, pause. Sorry. Hey, Chef Brian. Welcome, y'all. Appreciate y'all pulling up. Hey. Turn my phone off. Just everybody wanna call when I'm busy. Babe, hey, Valerie. Hey, I see. Showtime. Mommy, I see you, baby. Okay. Get all this stuff out. Hello. Welcome everybody to the point of view. I wanna welcome you. Hey, I'm your host.
My speeches.
Thank you guys so much for putting up on me. I appreciate y'all. Welcome again. I am your host, My speeches. And this beat brought to you by Roots, the producer. Purple bag beats. I need y'all to run that chat. We got some stuff to talk about today, y'all. We do this every Monday at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Again, I am your girl, My Speeches, and I'm coming to you guys today with all of the juicy teas. Yes, anything pop culture, I'm your girl. Music, arts, TV, radio. I got you. I see you tap out. I see y'all. Run that chat. Hey, we're warming up. Welcome to the point of view. Thank y'all. Thank y'all. Thank y'all. Thank y'all so much. I see y'all. Hey, producer. I see Dr. Soul. I see y'all. I see y'all. AB. I see you, Roots. I see you, Reese. I see you tap out. I see you still. Hey. I'll make sure y'all say something like it's a fave fest over here. Hey, baby girl 93, thank you so much. I appreciate y'all for pulling up on me. I appreciate y'all. We got some stuff. We got Todd Benjamin in the house. Hey, we're going to do it tonight. We're going to serve you right. Hey, Jimmy Joy, I see you, baby. I see y'all. All y'all, thank y'all for pulling up again. This is season 2, episode 4 of Point of View with My Speeches and Friends. You're listening to this. Let's go. I've researched, I don't go around doing no fake news. So I have researched these stories that are in the headlines, and I'm going to be bringing them directly to you. Because I know sometimes we're a little busy, you can't keep up with all the stuff that's going on. So I'm the one who's going to bring you all this stuff every week, on Monday at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Now, today, again, like I was saying earlier, we have Top Badge. Big Venom coming up through here. And he'll be here at the bottom half of the show. So that way you guys get a chance to know who he is, find out what he streams, all that good stuff, and then go over there and visit him as well. So today, we got a few things I want to get specific on that we'll be talking about. So today we'll be talking about Rihanna.
Yep.
I'm talking about Riri. We're going to be talking about Travis Scott.
Yeah,
we're talking about him. Yeah, Big Venom from Sports Talk. Absolutely. And we're going to be talking about A couple of other things. Adele canceled Vegas. I'm going to get into that. And we're going to talk about some other things that's going on in pop culture, hip-hop news, sports. He is the creator of Sports Talk with Big Venom. So we'll try to get his Super Bowl predictions and see who he's going to win the Super Bowl. He was good yesterday because he did predict that the Bengals would win, and they absolutely did. So I'm going to put $5 on whatever he's talking about. Yes, your Riri is, listen, okay. Let me go over here. So I want to make sure I'm not giving out no false information. Because I know what happened to Tasha K. I'm not going to be here. I ain't got no 1.2 million or 4.5 million. I don't have it. All right. So what we're going to get into immediately is this Rihanna news. Now, I'm not sure if you guys are familiar with Rihanna and what's his name? ASAP Rocky. ASAP Rocky. They've been friends for a long time. She was married to this billionaire tycoon guy. I mean, not married. She was in a relationship with him for 3 years. But here, January 2020, they broke up. And all of a sudden, we started seeing ASAP Rocky come around. He's doing all her skin campaign. Y'all see that campaign? She had that skincare campaign, and he was featured in that. And that's when it started getting hot and bothered up through there. So they ended up initially being friends first. And now they're out. They're exposed to everybody's relationship. But Riri just posted over the weekend. She had a pink trench coat on, and her little belly chin, and her stomach was sticking out, and they told her hands, walking through New York, and all of that stuff. So she is proud and pregnant. She did announce it. A lot of people missed it, but it's the picture with the belly. And she confirmed it. So Riri is pregnant by Travis Scott. In an interview, he said back in March of 2020, he said that Rihanna was the love of his life. And when you know, you just know. So Riri, pregnant, both of them are 33. This will be their first child. Yeah, ASAP Rocky. And pregnant is a bad girl. So both of them are 33. This will be their first child. And I just know that this baby is going to be the sharpest dressed baby ever.
Okay, sorry, Tom Cruise.
But this baby gonna be sharp. Because my mom is a Fenty designer, right? She just created this whole prep of things that's going on. ASAP Rocky kind of flies. So I mean, it's a little off-center, but it's like, okay, that works. You know what I mean? Get away with that. So I think they're gonna have a really cute baby with an enormous head because of all the thoughts that the baby's gonna have to have because of the parents. They said what they said. Okay, and then we're gonna get your point of view on that as well. Al Pacino, I see you, baby. No, they're gonna have a big head because Rihanna is extremely smart, right? So her head has to be big enough to hold that brain. That's all I'm saying. It's like Rocky, you know what I'm saying? He needs a brain too. So we're gonna let that live. Go leave that alone. Also in the news, we have. Oh, here we go, right here, y'all. Sorry. I was off for a second. We got Adele. Adele was here in Vegas. I'm in Vegas, y'all. I'm in the City of Lights. Okay, and she had a concert. She has this residency here in Las Vegas that was supposed to start up last weekend. But Adele said no. We won't do it. COVID has got my people all messed up. Everybody's sick. Blase. Well, come to find out.
Thank you, Butterfly God.
Adele was upset with the way that the rehearsals was going. Right? She didn't like the way the rehearsals went down. She just wasn't. She's a perfectionist. I don't know if y'all remember when George Michael passed. She was at the Grammys and she started her song off and she said, "No, cut the music in the middle of the show. Cut the music. I started off late. Let's start all over again." She's a perfectionist. So you ain't blame no coach. I didn't want to say it.
But there it is.
Boom. In the comments, they said, not me. and she blamed on COVID. But for the mere fact that she's a perfectionist like that, I get it. These people was paying $15,000 to $20,000 a ticket. And she canceled 24 hours before the show. I think I paid $100 for Jill Scott one time. $100. I was a little upset, but when I got there, it was absolutely worth it. Had she canceled and I spent $100, it'd have been a problem for me. Now these people come from different countries. They flew here. It was packed. Adele fans everywhere. Blasting her music. And then 24 hours before the thing, she don't show up. And then she calls on the telephone and tells everybody to meet them at the store. The ones that got rooms at the Caesar Palace. So come down to the gift shop. And she did a virtual call with them.
Yeah, so she's the same artist that stopped Careless Whisper in the middle of the song at the Grammys.
She didn't care who was watching. She did not care.
And then on top of Adele canceling everything, everybody here in Vegas.
Travis Scott got canceled, y'all. He got canceled from Coachella. He was supposed to be one of the headliners of Coachella, but concert goers and other victims of the people that were murdered and stabbed the last concert he had, all those people band together and stopped the vendor from hosting him in the Coachella event. So Travis Scott has been canceled from the Coachella lineup this year, and he has been replaced with Harry Styles.
Yeah, he's been replaced with Harry Styles.
So no more Travis Scott world gonna be there. But his fans band together against them and said, you know what, we think that's not his fault. We think that y'all should let him back in. We're not going to buy the tickets next year and so on and so on. And they got a petition signed with over 6,000 signatures to add into next year's one. And this year they're going to let it live because they feel like, okay, we're going to let y'all have that. We know the incident happened. We're not going to deny that, but we're going to let y'all have that next year. It didn't happen before, as far as canceling him from Coachella. Coachella's big for him, so that's that. And then also the statue from Kobe Bryant and Gigi went up at the crash site where the accident happened. Shout out and prayers to all the families that lost their loved ones. Those nine people total in that plane that crashed and they perished. So to me personally, I feel like it should have been a statue of all of those people. Not just them. I understand that those two were the socialites or whatever, but have some respect. If you're going to put it at the crash site, all of them lost their lives there. Definitely put it at the crash site with all of them there. Hey, Queen K, welcome, guys, again. You guys are watching Point of View with my speeches and friends. I am your host. You guys are my friends. We got some special people in the audience today that's going to tap in on some of these topics that we talked about. I do this every Monday at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so make sure y'all tune in. I appreciate y'all. So let me just go over. There's one more thing. Here's another thing. Kodak Black. Y'all, Kodak Black is back in the news again. I don't know if y'all remember when he went to jail. He went to jail before for firearms. He was falsifying documents to buy a firearm. And that's why he went to jail. Okay, that was the first time. That's when he was talking about Nipsey Hussle and all of those people, right? So he was talking to Lauren London, talking about Nipsey gone, give me a chance. Then he went to jail for falsifying information. Well, at the end of his presidency, number 45 gave him a pardon. And the man was free. Nobody heard from Kodak Black, right? Nobody heard from him. Nobody seen nothing. We didn't even know he was out. So while he was out, in January he pardoned him before he left. And then, or December, he left. And then in March, he gets arrested again. For assault. Kodak Black got arrested for assault. It was initially a rape charge, but he pled to a lesser charge of assault on a teenage girl in a hotel room down south somewhere. So that dude
Then he got probation for that crime. Okay. Then he turned around in January this year, 2022. Okay, it's 31 days in this month. Kodak Black is arrested again for trespassing. Now, I don't know who needs to hear this, but when I tell you that boy needs to stay where he was. Sometimes they just stay where they was, but he's a humanitarian too. I already give a lot back to the community. Can we just keep him out of jail? Can we work on that part? Like, come on, Kodak Black. So here's the scoop. Rihanna's pregnant by ASAP Rocky. They're happy, about to have a baby. We waiting on the new outfits to come out. All right, Kodak Black is in jail. I mean, in and out of jail again. Travis Scott got canceled from Coachella. And Adele canceled Vegas. Who does she think she is? You know, so those are the things I'm talking about. And I have a few other trinkets up in here, too. We have our guest, top bad Venom, coming in here on the second half of the show. But I want to get y'all's opinion on these topics that we're talking about so far. So if I can have my guests, yeah, pop up into the box. I'm in the box. I do, baby. Salute everybody. Shout out to everybody in here. I appreciate y'all for pulling up on me. All right. God bless you, y'all. Lord. Here we go. Uh-oh.
Trouble.
Here comes trouble.
I'll be nice today, but... I got something to say about this. Rihanna couldn't do it. Drake couldn't do it. I ain't doing nothing. Thank you. I love y'all. Go, T2. Yes, baby. I'm loving the thing. You are on today. Damn. So listen. Thank you. What do you think about
Kodak Black going in another one like this? Where's his grandmama? He's doing too much. He need a whooping. He need his mama to come pop somebody.
Because listen, we need our black men out here. And come on. How many times you got to go to prison and you making money and wasting your money? You wasting your money. He give me that money. He want to throw it away like that.
I think he needs counseling. That's what I hear. I believe that to be true. Sometimes people don't like to admit that they need counseling. Sometimes okay people is okay. So you know what? All right, somebody help me. Help me. I go to a counselor. This one over here to send me to a damn counselor. Y'all, I don't need no counselor, but I am gonna go. She said I cussed too much. I'm trying to stop cussing. Okay, what about this Adele with these $15,000 tickets that she has?
Adele, I love Adele. But listen here, you ain't worth that much to $15,000 tickets. I would have forgave D and Mexican people $15,000 tickets, but not Adele.
You know what, I like some of these too, but I don't think I can sit through a whole concert. That's just me. No, I'm not looking for you. I'm not looking for you. Travis Scott got canceled for all those people that got attacked and stuff like that. Travis, I can't see. He needs Jesus. He needs to cut that nut down. I want to be political.
But I'm saved. You know, y'all see me on Inspiration Sundays sometimes, and I always want to go lay hands on the young man. You know, the whole, just throw some water on you. Cause something ain't right. All of a sudden, something's not right with that, y'all.
And you know, as sad as it is, you would think that some people would say, hey, hold on, brother. Slow your roll. You don't really need to work.
Yeah, they're baby number two.
So yeah, I agree. Look at Sorority too. Y'all make sure y'all. Sorority too. Tell Sorority. I mean, Sorority that I love her. And I miss her. But I love seeing you. I'm seeing if she can bring me out more. She be hiding me and anything, you know. I've been trying to pop out. She told me I had a show to pee on the day. I'm like, I'm playing on my feet. I got to get my bangs.
What?
I'm
finally let me out. She won't even let me on the hip hop playground. She think I'm going to take over. But that's fine. I ain't going to take over.
Yeah, you know what? You know what? You're a show. You can come back whenever you want to. Y'all give it up for my special guest.
Look off.
Ooh,
hello. I love it. Y'all just need to know. Okay, y'all need to know. So, I do have other guests in the audience too. I want to get their point of view on these topics as well, and then we'll get into some more themes as well. So you guys won't be hearing me. I'm waiting on my second special guest to pull up. While I got you guys' attention, make sure you guys fade each other up. Make sure you guys follow me on all social media platforms. You guys are watching Point of View with my speeches and friends. You guys are my friends. We got some people that got some opinions and some point of views about what we're talking about today. So we're going to get into some things. I've got my next guest in the box. Y'all make sure that y'all... Y'all research this stuff. All this stuff. I'm saying it's the truth. Okay? It's the truth. Okay, we got Top Man Jamila Joe.
Here we go.
What happened? That's okay. Tag the one to be great. Okay, here we go.
Okay, well, hold on then.
Boom. Damn.
Kodak Black for the rest of the game. I don't know.
Kobe Bryant and Gigi Kobe Bryant and Carter did a statue at the crash site.
Oh yeah! Oh my God! Oh
okay.
I don't know.
All right, y'all. Thank y'all so much again. You guys are watching, tuned in to the point of view with Peachez and Friends. We're talking about everything pop culture. And we got, here we go. One more time. We got Jamila in the house. Hey, we got Jamila in the house. You better watch your mouth. Okay. Boom.
Hey everyone, I'm about to chime in. Okay, all right, so which one do we talk about first? Rihanna, Travis Scott, baby? No, it's Rocky, baby. You gotta have baby with what they can do. She's gonna do well. Hello, it's something wrong with you. Okay, now listen, here's how we know that Adele canceled that concert because she's going through a rough breakup with her boyfriend. We know because whenever she has a hit. song is always got to do with something sad from a relationship. So some of us are emotional thinkers, and you know we can just be honest, and if our heart is not in it, we don't want to do it. So she probably was like, look, I want to, it wasn't a good choice because whenever you make a decision based on emotions, and you have a contract, it's not a good choice. But I probably recognize that she made that choice. She almost probably saying like to him, baby, please come back.
I put my money on the line for you, darling. This money don't mean nothing about you. So she's probably being a drama queen right now, counseling that because that's not a wise decision. And it also tells you she does not value her relationship with her fans. She does not value her relationship with her management. She does not value her commitment. What she values is her heart connections. And unfortunately, we see a lot of celebrities yearning for something real. They want a real relationship. So she's saying, listen, I'm ready to put this thing all on the line for love.
But you know what? Love should have brought you home last night, baby.
We're going to get the money. Okay. What's the other topic, sis?
We got Travis Scott getting canceled at Coachella. Travis Scott was in there.
We have to be responsible as creators. He was not being responsible once he saw promotion. His management team should have shut that thing down. If he didn't do it, people that watch you back, you got to be careful who you have around you. But what they were saying, look at the things. He got canceled and Adele canceled her. All right, two different things. They should have canceled that. But maybe they need to be more than, you know, we're going to move forward with this because if you don't get canceled, we might not get paid. But somebody's life could have been saved. And maybe Adele is crying out saying, hey, I'm trying to save my life. I can't give y'all what I want to give y'all. The way I'm doing, somehow I'm feeling. But she didn't get herself together. She's a pup. I would have sat her right on top of the baby. Girl, these people paying $1,500 a ticket. I will find you, man. $10,000 a ticket. I will find you, man. Okay.
Hey, come with me, baby. Okay.
Hello.
I'm gonna hook up. Period.
I
I agree because a lot of times we don't even know that a lot of these people are depressed and all that good stuff until you see the signs of it, like Britney Spears. You know she was going through stuff until she shaved her hair off. You're like, oh, she's tripping. No, she's not tripping. She's actually going through some stuff. So that's shout out to everybody in here.
I hope that her people check on her because that is a cry out for help. Whenever someone counts a major commitment like that is a monetary thing, something major and huge that people die for, to have a residency in Las Vegas or anywhere, it's just like, are you kidding me? So she really needs somebody to talk to her. She needs to sit on Oprah Winfrey's couch or something because... Where she's going through, she really needs somebody to talk to her so she can get through what she's getting through and she can put her stuff on business on the side.
But that's just like being on here. You know, sometimes you don't feel like you want to get on here, but if you have obligations, you have to do it, right?
You know what? She's still in Vegas. I should go. I'm going to go up to the strip and see if I can't find it and have a conversation with her. Put on. Okay. Kobe Bryant's statue, him and the baby at the crash site. Do you think that's a good place for it to be? Do you think it should have been somewhere else? Do you think that it should have included all the victims or what? At the crash site, if it's going to be the crash site.
I don't know, that's a touchy thing. Respectfully, that man did a lot. I have a lot of respect. Kobe Bryant, I didn't realize how he got overshadowed. I mean, he is the biggest, but so many other people that passed at the same accident, that were along with him. So he is who he is. So to give acknowledgement to him, definitely, I think, is appropriate. I don't know about the crash site, because what about my babies?
My baby was a good issue.
No, parents kind of disrespectful thing, unless it can be inclusive. Because if you're doing it at the crash site, guess what? They weren't the only two. So then you're doing privilege. People always talk about white privilege, but then you're doing celebrity privilege, which is not cool either. So that's all I got to say.
Pray Thursday, 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 Thursday,
I'm gonna get into some more tea. But I'm gonna do it briefly. Okay. All right, let me see here. Okay. So I do have some more. Tia wanna drop new music alert. Okay, y'all. New music alert. Can't play it right now, but go look it up. Google it. Watch the video. That song is off the charts. Let me see. I'm talking about Rihanna. Rihanna's pregnant. Rihanna's pregnant. Rihanna's pregnant. Rihanna's pregnant by ASAP Rocky. He did it. Home run. Drake probably needs a drink right now. He really thought he was trying. So we got Travis Scott got canceled from Coachella. Adele canceled Vegas. Kodak Black can't stay out of jail. That's what I'm talking about today, people. And also, like I said, Chris Brown got new music out. It's called Iffy. He's basically, I think Chris Brown did a good comeback from his cancellation. You know what I mean? Remember when they canceled Chris Brown because of him and Rihanna's beef, what they had with whoever? I'm like the way they canceled R. Kelly. When they canceled R. Kelly, they canceled him for good. He was done. It was a wrap. You know what I mean? But Chris Brown, like, okay. We're gonna let you live, Chris Breezy, and he stayed out of the way. He stayed out of the limelight. He stayed out of, he was on probationary, things like that. Baby Fever's coming in the building. So we got that. Kodak Black, we're gonna get him some counseling. We're also gonna get him a haircut, according to Queen K. She's tired of him looking like Lisa Simpson, and she really is. Okay. In other news, y'all. Keisha Cole's is having a discrepancy with the young lady. Is it Mooney Long? Mooney Long is the young lady that sings that song, Yours, Mine, Ours, I can do this thing for hours. I can talk to you for hours. I know that song is going around viral on TikTok and everything. Well, baby, let me tell you the tea.
It's called Hours. Let me tell you the tea. That was Keisha Cole's song.
She sat down in the studio with this young lady, paid her money, and poured her heart out for this lady to write her a song. Okay? Let's fast forward a little bit. Yeah, I know Keisha Cole had Baby Daddy that was about 15 to 25 years old. I'm not sure exactly how old he was. He was a lot younger than her, and her and he were going back and forth fighting, and she broke up with her baby daddy, and she was like, forget the music industry. She does it about every breakup, she does this. Forget music, I'm not singing no more, I'm done with it. She told her, girl, I'm retired. I'm done singing. So a girl sat on the song for a couple of years. And y'all know she's been going through some things. She lost her mom. She had a baby and all this stuff was going on. Well, the girl gave the song to someone else. It's this money loan chick. And it's a hit. It is not oily out the park. Everybody downloaded it. I was going to do it on TikTok. But I can't get the verbiage right. I'm going to do it on TikTok. So the lady is saying that Keisha Cole told her she don't want to do music no more. So she paid her for her time and she wrote the song for Keisha, but she had to sell it because somebody else needed it. What is your opinion on her selling that woman's song without her permission? Let's get into that. And also in other news, thank you, Johnny Dragon. In other news, we have Jermaine Dupri. Jermaine Dupri. Got a vegan ice cream, y'all. He got a vegan ice cream. I think I love him. He does. He has a vegan ice cream. It's called JD's Vegan, and it's sold at Walmart on the third shelf. It's where they sell that. Yes, all different flavors, pistachio, butter. Brat was on her Instagram promoting it, and that's where I went and looked into it. He's been trying to come up with this formula for vegan ice cream that tastes actually like ice cream. So if y'all in Walmart somewhere, pick up some. Tell me how it is. I can't go in Walmart because I spend more than $300 on ice cream. I'm just saying. It's not even ice cream. I'm even going there for that other stuff. I get ice cream. I get ice cream every single time. Okay, so this is the part of the show. I don't know where that other person is. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to keep it going. Y'all can comment down in the below. Y'all can hop back up in the box. It doesn't matter to me. Whoever wants to hop in, we're going to play over, under. All right? So this is the part of the show where I play over, under with you guys. All right? So we got the Super Bowl coming up. Right? Who's playing again? The Bengals?
Yeah, over under.
You boxed?
Okay.
Over under is where we take things and we say, this is overrated. This is underrated. This is overrated. This is underrated. Okay, so since we got the Super Bowl coming up, I know some answers to this. I think it's the Rams and the Bengals.
The Rams and the Bengals are playing in the Super Bowl.
Which team is more overrated?
Bengals
or the Rams? Come on, somebody.
Who's the Chiefs? The Chiefs are overrated.
Big Hunter said the Chiefs. They ain't over there yet. Both underrated?
Okay.
So who do you guys have for the Super Bowl?
Who do you have?
You got the Rams. You know what? I'm going to tell y'all something about these California teams. They got the Rams. What's the other one? LA Chargers. Chargers and the 49ers. It used to be the Raiders. The Raiders are here in Vegas now, causing a muck. I think the Raiders are overrated. Go ahead and say that. Rams going to win? Write that down. Because I'm not supposed to get a prediction. So let me see. The Rams is going to win. All right, Rams. That's my first Rams. Anybody else in the Rams? Okay,
no problem.
And then overrated, underrated. Dallas Cowboys. America's team. They represent the whole America. The last time they won a Super Bowl. Hello? The Rams might win. Overrated. We got some. Hold on. Y'all not talking about them like that. Okay, Stillers World's in the building. We don't let him have that. Because clearly he has some type of animosity towards the Cowboys. America's team. Okay. Underrated. Tom Brady. Is he underrated or overrated?
Overrated.
The team is still going all right without him, but yeah, Steelers all day. Okay, Steelers all day. All right, I don't want to start no problems in there. I don't know how many Steelers fans we have in here. I think you're the first, second Steelers fan I ever met in my life. So welcome to the live. I appreciate y'all. Again, you guys are watching. Point of view with my speech to friends. You are getting into over and under right now. So we're gonna dip off of that and go into celebrities. I always ask this question. LeBron James.
Overrated. Underrated.
Somebody give me the truth. Please and thank you.
Overrated.
LeBron.
I'm gonna say this.
LeBron James is trying to fill somebody's shoes. He could never ever feel that somebody can do that. No, there's no way he can do that. And I think that he's riding the coattails of the last wins that he had on another team. I need him to do something on this team that he owned right now. So I respect him as a father, as a husband, but not a player. Okay, Sheen is not playing. Okay. All right. Underrated. Overrated. Michael Jordan sneakers.
The Jordan Air Force One, overrated. The three, four hundred dollar, five hundred dollar shoes.
You can't even walk right here because they're not made for human foot. They're made to look at. You just want to put some shoes up on the wall and just say, you know what? We don't let y'all live. Yes. I don't have no Air Force Jordans myself either.
Okay.
Now. I'm gonna need y'all to bear with me. I don't want nobody to have no beef with me, okay? All right. Oprah Winfrey. Is she overrated or underrated? Oprah Winfrey. Who? Overrated or underrated? Well, y'all ready to hold up? All right, y'all look like Jamila taking her earrings off right now. I'm gonna need everybody to get low. She's about to take her earrings off and get ready to fight somebody. Underrated? Dr. Surreal. Watch yourself, don't talk about Oprah. Don't say that bad about Oprah. All right, I'm gonna ask y'all this. I mean, musically, I need y'all to be realistic. Okay. Usher got a residency here. Usher overrated or underrated? His thing is high too. I've been trying to sell a kidney to get to one of his concerts. I mean, Usher, is he overrated or under? How about my way? What about the commitment Michael Jordan made?
Listen, what about the commitment Michael Jordan made?
He made the commitment to the shoes, baby. Usher should have been in the game. He was like three. Wait a minute. I'm sorry. I can't see. I don't look like that. Michael Jordan, I didn't see the Michael Jordan comment. Do it again. Sorry, babe. Give it up for Usher. I love Usher. I love Usher. Usher is the truth. All right. Oh, another thing too, y'all. Underrated.
Overrated. Reality TV. I'm not talking about the TV that y'all watching right now.
I'm talking about the TV that's loving hip hop and other shows and stuff. Is it underrated or overrated? Overrated. It is overrated. Because you know what? I'm going to tell you right now. Ain't no better place to be than right here on live. I'm going to tell you why. Because you see everything that's happening. It's not pre-recorded. There's no script. Everybody knows their position, but at the same time, everybody's always going to be themselves. When you lie, there's no cut. Start that over again. No, this is live TV, baby. This is what we're doing. Welcome to Point of View with my Peaches and Friends. I was Point of View with Peaches and Friends. I'm your host, my Peaches. And today we've been getting into several different social epithets, I want to say. We've been super nosy today, and that's my job here. That's my job to be extra nosy. We found out today that Rihanna is pregnant. We found out it's that racket, it's the baby Peppy that we know of so far. I love her, I'm leaving alone. ASAP Rocky, her baby Peppy. Travis Scott got canceled from the Coachella. Adele. Kodak Black, we're going to get him some brand counselors over there for him. Keisha Cole, he stopped pouring her heart out every time she has an album coming out, especially to a ghostwriter. She knows better than that, she's supposed to write on her own. The statue of Kobe Bryant and Jim went up. So we've talked about those things. Also, you guys, for the Super Bowl weekend is coming up. I'm going to go with the Bengals only because I'm going against California, which I'm from there, but I'm going to go with the Bengals. I said what I said, if y'all see me crying next week, you know what happened. But I'm going to tell y'all who's going to be on the halftime show. This is why I really watch the Super Bowl, okay? This is why I really watched the Super Bowl. I really watched the Super Bowl for the halftime show and to see all the tight ends running across the screen, right? So this year they have Dr. Dre. Dr. Dre. Kendrick Lamar. Okay. And Mary J. Blige. Mary J. Blige is going to be part of the halftime show with Kendrick Lamar. And Dr. Dre is going to be lit. So y'all make sure y'all tune in for that. Right now, we're getting ready to close out this show. I'm going to have Dr. Soreal come in here, you guys. She's going to teach us some breathing techniques that we all can use. And then I'm going to close out the show. But I want to thank everybody in here for coming in today. Do not leave. I still got some OT. I just can't stop. Dr. Soreal, box up. We're going to get this breathing technique going so that way we can be calm, cool, and collected. Right.
Hey, good evening, everyone. Awesome show. Did y'all love all of that? That was a whole lot for us to get, right?
So now we just want to breathe all of that in.
I've been asked on many occasions when you're in a space where you can't really get fully into your practice of meditation, how do we get there? 10 deep breaths will get us there. So we're going to do 10 deep breaths. We're going to breathe really deep in through our nose and through our nose and out through our mouth, but we're going to give a big sigh, like, ha, like you're pushing it all the way out. So, in one, hold it.
For three,
and out. Ha.
Let's do that.
Eight more times. Ha. Ha. Your sympathetic nervous system is calming down, you are able to focus and make a better decision. For a deeper into that, for meditation, come and join me in the morning. I will see you guys at 10 a.m. for meditation and medication. We'll always have something new. See you later. I love you. Breathe easy. Namaste.
Hey, I'm giving up Dr. Soreal in the field. Let me tell y'all something about that breathing. Breathing really works. Let me tell y'all why.
It's close to like road rage.
I'm like, breathe. Namaste. All right, you guys. So, again, next week, we will be having more guests. We'll have different guests every week coming in to talk with us about these things that's going on in our pop culture, music, trivia. We'll have all that stuff going on here. But I want you guys to do this for me. Y'all can, I know y'all ain't at school or nothing like that, and nobody has to, don't nobody tell you what to do and all that good stuff. But I want you guys to do your homework this weekend or this week, sometime this week if you can. Go and watch the documentary, Demeter Joe. I think it's called Demeter Joe. It's Janet Jackson's documentary. She goes over her life and you know what she went through, going through the music industry and all the relationships and stuff that she had. So I would recommend someone told me about it. Right, someone told me about it, and I'm actually going to take the time out to watch it. So that way I can come back and get the information to you guys as well. So that's the movie to watch out. Make sure you guys download that new Chris Brown. If you can download that new Chris Brown song. Go fact find, go double check what I said. If there's something I said that you guys don't believe is the truth, somebody told y'all something different, come back to me. But I guarantee they're going to be like, yep, Peachez was right. So y'all make sure y'all tune in every Monday at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Supporting you with Peachez and friends. If you got something interesting that you want to talk about and want to get somebody's point of view on, Follow me on all social media platforms. That's MySpeeches 5.0. That's where you'll find me. And make sure that you guys tune in to this episode as well. It's also going to be on my YouTube channel. And I appreciate you guys so much for pulling up on me. Again, this beat is brought to you by Purple Bag Beats. I thank you guys so much for pulling up on me. I appreciate y'all. I love it. Okay, that's it. Do you have anything else? Anybody else? Make sure y'all tune in to all the feature shows tonight. We got Hidden Voices with Popcorn Poppy coming up. We got hidden voices with Popcorn Poppy coming up. Okay.
Awesome sauce.
Thank y'all. Appreciate y'all. I love it here. Hey. Love Queen in the house. Okay.
Hey, I'm not moving. Don't you shut me down, Miss Peachez, my Peachez. I'm sitting in the rest area. I had to work overtime dealing with black people. Okay, so I just wanted to tell you that Riri, y'all leave Riri alone. Don't y'all bother Miss Riri. Rihanna know who her baby daddy is. Rihanna know who her baby daddy is. Leave Rihanna alone. You hear me? Rihanna. Well, you just leave me alone. Now, go on. What you need to do is go on back and check on that one baby that y'all trying to make. What's her name? Keith. You know who I'm talking about. Yeah, that's the baby y'all need to keep your eye on.
Baby fit coming out.
Leave that baby alone. Bella, that's right, Dr. So-Will. Miss Bella. Y'all keep your eye on Bella. Let's see how she's gonna turn out, okay? Hopefully we can keep her out of foster care. Just keep in mind, y'all need to sign up for foster care now, okay? We need more people in foster care. Dr. So-Will, I need you to sign up. Reese Cup.
Sign up.
Jamila Joyce.
Sign up
for the foster care program, okay?
Okay.
You just never know whose child you might end up with, Bella. You might end up with Bella. I love y'all. Thank you, Mama's Peachez. Mama's Peachez. Yeah. Hey.
Voila.
Y'all, thank you again so much for tuning in. I appreciate all the love, all the support. Y'all tell a friend, tell a friend next to a friend. Don't somebody, next to somebody. The Peachez Live every Monday at 6 p.m. doing her thing, Eastern Standard Time, and I'm gonna have to be out on that note again. Next week we're gonna be talking about Janet Jackson, whatever else happened this week. You know me, soon as this is over, I'm gonna do my research. Okay, who else is next? What's good? Go check out Jermaine Dupri's ice cream.
Make sure you guys check out Jamila Joy this Thursday, Creative Vibe. Check out Storm Royalty this Wednesday. I will be on that show this Wednesday. The Hip Hop Playground. We doing some trivia. It's going up. Me and Sexy Red Ma, we going in there. And of course, they're gonna take each other. Hip Hop Playground every Wednesday at 6 p.m. Right? Jamila Joy. Y'all catch Queen K on Creative Vibe every week. She in that thing. So y'all make sure y'all pull up. Always working. I'm the trivia queen. I don't know who King is, but I'm the queen. Okay. All things hip hop, y'all pull up on Storm Royalty this Wednesday. Make sure y'all support that sister. Make sure y'all support Jamila Joy. I appreciate y'all again for coming out. Producer, I see y'all. Thank you guys to all my guests. And we are A-R-A-P. I'm going to stop the recording. Alexa, play.